डियर स्टूडेंट्स, टुडे आई वुड लाइक टू टीच यू रीड्स. देयर आर फाइव रीड्स गिवन इन योर सिलेबस, बट ओनली टू आर वेरी वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट, हेबस कार्पस एंड मैनमस. आई फर्स्ट वन आई वुड लाइक टू टीच यू वॉट इज रीड. रीड इज ए काइंड ऑफ ऑर्डर इशूड बाई सुप्रीम कोर्ट एंड हाई कोर्ट. सुप्रीम कोर्ट is very much empowered to issue the writ, and all high courts, Patna High Court, Allahabad High Court, Lucknow Bench, and how many high courts are there? All high courts are very much permitted to issue the writ. Please pay attention. So there are, how many writs are there? Five writs. Now one question is there. Name the court those are empowered to issue the writ. Your answer will be there: High Courts and Supreme Court. Second question: What is need to issue the writ? If fundamental rights will be violated, then only Supreme Court and High Court are empowered to issue the writ. So, dear students, today I am going to explain about writs. There are five writs, and two are very very important. First one, habeas corpus, and second one, mandamus, third one, writ of prohibition, and fourth one, writ of certiorari, and last one, quo warranto. One by one, I'll explain. So you have to focus on first two. I'll teach all five, but you have to learn only two. Okay, that is very, very important. First one, habeas corpus, it means, it is a Latin word. It means to have the body. By issuing such a writ, the High Court or Supreme Court can get the body of any person released if he has been unlawfully detained by a person or a group of a person or by state. This writ is thus a great safeguard for the personal freedom of citizen. Dear students, I have taught you regarding Article 32 and Article 226. Please pay attention, very easy way I would like to teach you. Suppose if any dispute will be there, so first one, normal rule is there, we have to approach to district court, then we can approach to high court, then finally we can approach to supreme court if our problem will be not sorted out, we will not get justice. But one situation is there, in that one, directly we can approach to High Court or Supreme Court. Dear students, if our fundamental rights has been violated, so our forefather framed the constitution, and very rich constitution we have, very meaningful constitution we have, and in that constitution, Article 32 is there and Article 226 is there. According to Article 32, if fundamental rights will be violated, so people can approach to High Court, Supreme Court. And according to Article 226, people can approach to High Court. Are you getting my point? Means by Article 32, we can approach to Supreme Court if fundamental rights will be violated. And according to Article 226, we can approach to High Court if our fundamental rights will be violated. Getting? If our fundamental rights will be violated, we can directly approach to Supreme Court. And what Supreme Court and High Court, both court, we can approach both court. Okay, if your main sir fundamental rights have been violated, so main sir can approach to nearest one, Gorakhpur to Lucknow or Allahabad, I can go there. Okay, so it will be nearest for me, that's why I'll prefer Allahabad or Lucknow. Lucknow I'll prefer, because Lucknow is nearest one. Suppose if I am living in Greater Noida, then what will be my preference? I'll go to Supreme Court, because Delhi will be nearest one. So these articles has been framed because for availability, easy availability for the common people. And people can approach to Supreme Court or High Court according to their wish, and respective court will issue the writ for the protection of the fundamental rights. So suppose your Mahen sir has been detained illegally by any person or group of person or by state. my family member can approach to Supreme Court or High Court. And High Court and Supreme Court will issue the order, issue the writ, habeas corpus. Means it is law that within 24 hours I will be represented before the magistrate, but I have been detained illegally. But if legally I have detained, suppose I am a culprit, I have killed any person, police detained, then the different issue. I am talking about illegally if I have been detained, then my fundamental rights will be violated. Then my family can approach to High Court, my father can approach to High Court or Supreme Court. Okay, and High Court and Supreme Court will issue the writ. Means I have the to have the body, means that body, my answer body, must be represent before the magistrate. Clear? And then proceeding will be started. First point clear? Now second point is there, mandamus. It is also Latin word, means we order. It is a command or order from superior court to lower or administrative authority to perform certain duty. Suppose any person, any officer, public servant is there, he is not discharging his duty and fundamental rights has been violated, so person can approach to High Court and Supreme Court, and High Court and Supreme Court will issue mandamus. Means it is a order, and you are public servant, you have to discharge your duty. Suppose you still that person is not listening, then it will be considered contempt of court. Contempt of court means disrespect shown to the court. Disrespect shown to the court means disrespect shown to the constitution, and then person can be arrested. Are you getting my point? Okay, so these are important point, first and second. So habeas corpus means we have the body, this keyword is there, must be written. Mandamus means we order. We order means this is a command or order given by superior court to lower court. Are you getting my point? That is very, very important. Now third writ is there, writ of prohibition. The writ of prohibition is an order issued by the superior court to lower court to stop the proceeding in a case which might be excess of the jurisdiction of the lower court. Suppose any case is there and hearing going on, and if Supreme Court observe that it is out of the jurisdiction of the lower court, okay, then upper court can issue. Upper court means two court, High Court and Supreme Court, can issue the writ of prohibition, means stop the proceeding. And who will take concern this one? Supreme Court or higher court will take concern. And last fourth one, writ of certiorari. The writ is issued by the superior court to judicial authority desiring to be informed what is going on. Means what is going on in lower court, upper court can issue the writ, and upper court wanted to know what is the status. Through in it appears similar to the writ of prohibition. There is a difference. Writ of prohibition is issued when certain proceedings are going on, and writ of certiorari is issued after the order has already been passed by the lower court. Please pay attention. Writ of prohibition means proceeding started, and during the proceeding superior court will order stop this one because it is out of your jurisdiction. And writ of certiorari means when lower court already passed the verdict, given the order, okay, then this writ will be issued. Now last one, quo warranto. It means by what order. It is issued when a person has observed any office. This writ does prevent public officers from forcibly or wrongly holding a high public office. Suppose any person is there and he is not leaving his post, transfer order taken place, then also not leaving, then respective person can approach to High Court or Supreme Court, and High Court and Supreme Court will issue the writ. And if still person is not leaving his post, okay, then it will be considered contempt of court. And contempt of court means disrespect to the court, and after that person can be arrested. It will be shown that respect to the constitution, disrespect to the constitution. So only this much. So read must be learned. Thank you.